Hello everyone, welcome to this module of the course Introduction to Social Entrepreneurship. I am Madhukar Shukla, I am a faculty at XLRI Jamshedpur, India. In this module, we will be discussing the business and social entrepreneurship and the two corresponding kind of entrepreneurs, the business entrepreneurs and the social entrepreneurs. We will look at how they differ in terms of the outcomes which they aim to achieve and correspondingly the kind of strategic choices which they make and the way they run their businesses. One thing we must appreciate that whether it's business or social entrepreneurship, entrepreneurship is about wealth creation. So in that sense, both business and social entrepreneurs are similar, that they are wealth creators. The difference, however, lies in the way they define the nature of wealth and correspondingly the way they try to create the wealth. Normally when we talk about wealth, the conventional popular connotation is wealth is similar to finances or economic capital. But over a period of time, or especially during the recent years, there is a growing realization that when we talk about wealth of a society, it is more than just GDP and per capita income and savings, etc., etc. In fact, from 2012, United Nations has started tracking the what they call the Inclusive Wealth Index, which is a kind of a triple bottom line for the societies and nations, and which includes not just the financial wealth, which is of course the GDP, the income, the savings, etc., etc., but also the other two kinds of wealth. So the wealth is much more diverse and much more inclusive as compared to just the financial wealth. So if you look at the social wealth of a society or a community or a nation, this would include things like what is the educational level, skill level, how is the healthcare system, how robust are the social systems, how inclusive is the political structure, the freedom, well-being, etc., etc. And the environmental wealth includes things like your fertile agricultural land, minerals, forests, rivers, lakes, etc. In context of a topic, the business entrepreneurs primarily focus on the financial wealth, whereas the operational definition for social entrepreneurs is much more diverse, which includes not just the financial wealth but also the social and environmental wealth. And that is the first difference which one finds between the business and social entrepreneurs, that business entrepreneurs, the motive and the goal is to generate more financial wealth, whereas for the social entrepreneurs, it's to generate more diverse kind of wealth, which is more inclusive. The second part of, or second difference between a business and a social entrepreneur is, for whom is this wealth being created? Who accrues the benefit of the wealth which is being created? For business entrepreneur, the benefit of the wealth is for the entrepreneur, for the shareholders or the investors. Whereas social entrepreneurs aim to for wealth creation for the benefit of the community or the society which they serve. So these are the two very critical differences between business and social entrepreneur. One is the nature of wealth and whether it's just financial or it's more inclusive. And the second is for who's the beneficiary of the wealth, whether it's just the wealth creator, the entrepreneur or shareholder or investor, or it is the society as large. Now these two differences also create differences in the ways business and social entrepreneurs conduct their ventures. So being entrepreneurs, they may start with the, they may identify the same gap, they may start from the same idea, for example, take for example, the venture can start by identifying a gap of healthcare access in the rural population. Business entrepreneur can also create a venture or enterprise out of that, and a social entrepreneur would also do that. The difference comes in terms of the strategic choices which they make. Since business entrepreneur is looking at maximizing personal wealth or the financial wealth for the enterprise, for the entrepreneur, shareholder, investors, etc., they are more likely to target those segments which give more financial returns. For example, villages which have a large dense population, so it becomes easier to reach healthcare. The cost of reaching healthcare to people would be less. Focusing on those diseases and ailments which, even though may be infrequent, but have high margins. Focusing on high income group, because that's where returns would be high. As compared to that, the social entrepreneur, since the purpose is to create wealth for the society, for the segment, they would and a wealth of more diverse and inclusive kind, they would design their ventures around how does one reach quality, affordable healthcare to deep interior villages where healthcare services are not available, and that's where healthcare is perhaps more needed. How does it reach it to the ultra poor, the poorest of the poor, who can't afford it? Also, to look at those diseases or those ailments which have a larger impact. For example, in villages, the 80-85% of the diseases are waterborne, and they because of their impact, people lose their livelihoods, the healthcare costs go up. Although the treatment of these diseases is pretty inexpensive, and therefore it's very low margin business. But social entrepreneurs would focus more on these so that larger population is able to work, would be able to remain healthy, and so on and so forth. And therefore they also measure their success in different manners, because as we saw, for the business entrepreneur, the measure of success would be more in the financial terms, the profits, the turnover, the market share, etc. Whereas for the social entrepreneur, the success would be in terms of the impact it makes on the lives of the people. So if we go back to the same example, for the business entrepreneur, the measure of success would be market size or the revenue per patient or the cost per treatment, whether it has gone down or gone up, profits they were able to generate, etc., etc. Whereas for the social entrepreneur, the measures of success would be, for example, has the health indices of the community they are serving gone up? Have people saved on the healthcare costs because of these treatments? Have they been healthy and therefore were able to work, more number of days, and therefore their income has gone up, and so on. Or take another example of a venture which can be created out of a gap or an opportunity which lies with the agricultural farmers who are unable to reach urban markets and therefore are unable to get good returns. For the business entrepreneur, the success measures would be the volume of procurement, the profit per ton of sale, increase in turnover, and therefore the systems and processes would be designed to increase these success measures. Whereas for the social entrepreneur, the success measures would be in terms of whether the farmer's income has increased or not, whether the reduction in farmer's debt has happened or not, whether there's a reduction in the distress migration due to lack of livelihoods in the villages, whether that has been achieved or not. So these would be the kind of differences which they have. And the next difference is in terms of where they focus. So for the business entrepreneur, the purpose of business is maximizing profits. Whereas for social entrepreneur, it is important to generate surplus. So remaining profitable or generating surplus revenue is important. And it's important to look at this, you know, difference between profit maximization motive and profitable, remaining profitable, being profitable motive. So, you know, when the profit maximization primarily, you know, is focusing on the very purpose of the venture, that the reason why one started an enterprise or a venture is to generate as much profit as possible. And therefore, the earning of the entrepreneur or, you know, shareholders or investors would also go up. And it is also important that if you have more profit, therefore this venture can scale up, and if it scales up, there would be even more profits, and it will become a virtuous cycle to maximize profits. Being profitable and revenue surplus has a different reason and purpose, which is that being profitable ensures that for the social entrepreneur that the venture is self-sufficient. The way the venture is running, it utilizes its operations, they utilize the resources in the most efficient manner. It also gives the venture or social entrepreneur more autonomy and ownership of resource, and therefore more freedom to do what they would like to do, instead of depending on or being guided or even sometimes coerced by outside forces. So just to give a couple of examples, if you look at Lijjat Papad, Lijjat, as many of us know, was founded in 1959 by a lady called Jaswanti Ben Popat with seven other women to start rolling papers on their terrace. And these were illiterate, semi-literate women from low-income community. The purpose of the venture was to, you know, give economic freedom to these women. So it was, the purpose always remained with the empowerment, women empowerment. But the venture has grown. It is a for-profit venture. They have about 43,000-44,000 women members. The turnover is around 600-700 crores. Significant about 10% of that is exports, etc., etc. But the way they visualized, or the way they conceptualized the business, was quality goods at affordable, at reasonable prices. And why this reasonable prices? Are so that one will not depend on charity, donation, gift or grant. And that was the autonomy which they were. Or if you look at another example of Grameen Bank, as you know, was founded by Professor Muhammad Yunus. It also created the template for microcredit across the world. It's a for-profit venture, but then profit-making per se or profit-maximization per se is not the purpose. The purpose was to move the poor borrowers out of poverty, not making money. So, as he says, making profit is always recognized as a necessary condition of success, that we are covering the cost, the efficiency. And volume of profit is not important in money-making sense, but important indicator of efficiency. So that's the other difference. I mean, both can be for-profit ventures, but the social enterprise as well as the business enterprise. But the reason would be difference between the profit maximization and being profitable. The last difference is this, and which is often neglected, that business entrepreneurs work with the competitive analysis. For them, you know, maximizing the share of their markets so that they can earn more profit is an important part. Whereas for the social entrepreneur, the purpose of the enterprise is to serve the community. And more number of players there are to serve the community, the better would be for the community itself. And therefore, they work with a collaborative landscape. So finding the right partners, making partnerships and collaborations, finding who have the complementary skills or resources who can help them to deliver what the services or goods which they are trying to deliver is an important part for social entrepreneurs. So these are the five differences between the business and social entrepreneurs. It's also important to recognize that these differences do not mean that it is an either or. Business entrepreneurs also have a social impact. If the business entrepreneur hires 20 people, those 20 people at least have a security of getting regular income, and therefore they can plan their lives, educate their kids, invest in savings and insurance, etc., etc. Similarly, as we saw that for social entrepreneurs as well, the being profitable or making surplus is an important part of remaining sustainable and continue to keep making impact. So that's it for the time being. Thank you very much, and till we meet next time. Bye-bye.